Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. Robinson here again, and we're going to continue our studies. We're going to talk about unit rates. This show is dedicated to this fine young man, Jonathan. So let's talk about unit rate. If you need help with your homework, there's Dollar Teacher Homework Helpline at 212-777-3380. Monday to Thursdays, 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. Give them a call. They're very nice people. Don't forget to watch our tutorial videos on YouTube. My channel name is Dan Robinson, PKMS, Peekskill Middle School. Subscribe to our channel. Help us get to our next 1,000 subscribers. We're getting there. Write us a comment. I do write back. Give us a thumbs up if you like what we're doing. Check out our latest release, PKMS Math Prep 21. And as we speak, I'm working on Math Prep 22. You can tweet me at drobmath1. Don't forget to watch our show Math Time on Tuesdays, 4:30 p.m. to 5 p.m., only on Optimum Cablevision in Peekskill. All right. Let's get down to business. So we're going to be talking about unit rates. So let's get into it. The goal of this for us in English and Espanol is that you'll be able to write and solve a proportion to determine the unit rate. So we'll be doing more proportional reasoning, and we want to this time drag unit rates into it. So here's some notes that you should know. When we're talking about a unit rate, we're looking for the quantity of one. So that's very important. So when we're looking for the unit rate, that's really the cost of one or the quantity one we're interested in. So we'll get into that a little bit deeper. So here's some examples of unit rates. Like here, the first one, 35 mph. I've seen that on the street when I'm driving my car. That's how fast cars can go. Miles per hour. So miles per, and they don't write the 1 hour. So they're talking about 1 hour. So that's what we're talking about when we're talking about a unit rate. You can go 35 miles in 1 hour. That's the speed limit. If you go faster in that place, you may get a ticket. So be careful. Well, here's a butcher. Example number two. I see he has a scale with some meat on it. So I'm sure there's a price up there, $5.35. So we're talking about the cost per pound. And that again is 1 pound is what this butcher is doing. So again, it's the cost of one. So these are unit rates because they all include the quantity of one. So that's important. So we said one is the number we're talking about, so one. So let's do some examples dealing with unit rate. So let's make sure you understand it first. So if you don't understand, rewatch the video so you can know what we're talking about, because those definitions will play a critical role in what we go forward with. All right, so here we go. Kevin's family paid $28 admission for 7 people to go to the museum. What is the unit price? Okay, well, we got something going on here. If you remember, we can make a rate. And let's get a little color here. We want the unit price, and here we have a rate. What is the rate? We have in dollars over people. So the cost is $28 for 7 people. So let's write that down. There is our first fraction. That's a rate. The unit rate is when we're interested when the denominator is equal to 1. So that's the unit rate. So I want the denominator equal to 1. If you remember how we solved those problems, remember the video on solving proportions, you have to multiply the cross products. So that'll be 7 times question mark equals 28 times 1. And I get $4 for one person. How'd you get that, Dr. Rob? Can you just show a little bit more work? Sure, no problem. What I'm going to do is 7 times question mark equals 28 times 1, which is 28. So all I need to do is divide both sides by 7, and that'll give me question mark equals 4. For what? $4, because that 28 was dollars. The 7 were people. So if I were to change this into a fraction, I'd have to put the magical number 1 underneath that. And that's what I'm interested. 1 person. How much does it cost for that 1 person? Let's go down a little bit. That looks like a D. That's better. So $4 per 1 person. So that's the unit rate. We like to call it in 7th grade math, though, the COP. COP. Constants of proportionality. And we'll be getting into that a little later. So I hope you understood what we just did in order to find the unit rate. Let's give you one to try. So there are 18 bowlers on 6 lanes. I see Fred Flintstone there bowling. What is the unit rate? Oh, and I see some lanes over here, lane 18, 19. So this is a bowling alley. So see if you can set it up to find out what is the unit rate. We want to know 1. That's the most important thing. Our denominator has to equal 1. So set up your fraction or your proportions and then solve it for the 1. So I'll leave that for you to do. So I hope you understood what went on today. If you're not sure, rewatch the video, because guess what? We've come down to the end of our lesson. So if you need help with your homework, just dial the Teacher Homework Helpline at 212-777-3380, Monday to Thursday, 4 p.m. to 7 p.m. Give them a call. You can catch my videos on YouTube. My channel name is Dan Robinson. Subscribe to our channel. Give us a thumbs up if you like what we're doing. And write me a comment, because I do write you back. Check out our latest release, PKMS Math Prep 21. Watch our show, Math Time, on Tuesdays, 4:30 p.m. to 5 p.m. on Optimum Cablevision, only in Peekskill, on Channel 15. If you would like to study with me, or a worksheet on what we just did, write me at drobinson@peekskillschools.org, and I'll send you some information. Hey, Math Prep 22, the game show. So check out the commercial we have there. Just PKMS Math Prep 22, and you'll see our nice little commercial. I think you'll like it. So I thank you for watching our study skills series on unit rate dedicated to Jonathan. So keep up the good work, Jonathan. I'll see you in class. This is Dr. Rob signing off. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.